The concert was a sellout, not surprising since the promoters picked a hall that could seat less than 500. It attracted those who believe that punk rock is all about safety pin jewelry, the just plain curious, and the costume wearers seeking some publicity of their own. Takings at the bar exceeded those at the box office as the Pistols made a fashionably delayed appearance. But suddenly, there they were. Detectives from Atlanta's Vice Squad were in the audience, fearing the group might unleash something unutterably obscene. All they got was a bare chest, a lot of beer swigging, a few four-letter words from Johnny Rotten, and lyrics that might or might not have been objectionable. 45 minutes later, the Sex Pistols' first American concert was over. Ahead of them, appearances in Texas and California.
What did you think of the
They were great. They were great. If I could only make out the words, they'd be greater.
It was awful loud. It's, you know, real loud. It sounded like rock and roll along, you know, a few years ago and listened to punk rock.
Groom flinched there because somebody had just spit on him.
Maybe that's what punk rock is about, spitting on people.
Maybe so. I don't know what to say now.
To counter the Sex Pistols' reputation for not giving interviews, bass player Sid Vicious came out to tell reporters a little bit about his personal background.
When I was 12, I was just a kid. When I was 13 to 15, I was a skinhead. From 15 to 20, I've been a punk.